The demand for printing and writing grades are diminishing. And now these paper producers are looking for new materials, new products that they can produce with this existing infrastructure. And at the same time, we're seeing a growing demand for packaging, and especially the sustainable packaging. And some of the things we're looking at is, above all, recycled material from waste streams or from things like textiles or things you might not have thought of. My name is Paul Krocek. I am Director for Research and Business Development in the Department of Pulp, Paper and Packaging.
För oss så är områden som att kunna ersätta plast, till exempel plastpåsar som används idag blir kartonger istället, men också mer avancerade saker. Att kunna göra papper som kan formas eller papper som, varför inte papper som är genomskinliga eller papper som har barriäregenskaper och kan hålla inne och hålla produkter fräscha. Det kan också att få göra helt andra saker som att göra bränsle och energi. Jag heter Lars Sandberg. Jag jobbar med utveckling för ett företag som heter Billerud Korsnäs. Den här maskinen FEX, det är en möjlighet att efterlikna våra kommersiella maskiner. Alltså en som använder mindre material och har mer möjligheter att mäta och testa och prova olika typer av helt nya material.
When we work with companies, what typically happens is we first really need to understand the challenge. I mean, this challenge of sustainable packaging, it's a very broad concept. So we really need to understand what is the specific challenge. What functions does your material need to meet to have that same functionality that you have with another option? And we start to push the boundaries as far as we can, and we see how far can we come with a paper-based packaging. And once we start to identify a set of different concepts, well, now we need to go to reality. We need to start to produce this in a commercial setting. So that's where we come to this environment again to do these reality checks.
Nu när vi på Billerud Korsnäs ville testa vårt elektrodmaterial och testa verkligen hur går det här materialet att köra på en pressmaskin, då är det dyrt för oss att tillverka det här materialet. Det tar tid. Vi behöver bygga upp en egen process vid sidan om för att bearbeta det material som vi ska göra. Och hade vi inte kunnat göra det här i gramnivå och sen skala upp det med hjälp av RISE och med FEX-maskinen, då hade vi inte heller kunnat komma till nästa steg då, att tillverka den i tonskala i vår egen.
Some of the other major advantages with using this kind of a pilot facility really comes down to risk and financial rewards. This environment is really built for taking these risks. If things don't go quite right on a commercial machine, this will cost a lot of money. If things don't go right here, that's okay. We can very quickly re-stabilize things and try again. So in that sense, there's a large monetary benefit to testing in this environment. And this provides a lot of security for the commercial producers who want to actually produce this material in large volumes. Innovation is important because without it, we're going to stand still. We need to be innovative. We need to be innovative to meet these global challenges. We need to invest in R&D. We need to be willing to take risks. And all of this comes under innovation. Because the world is changing, we have to make these changes. Somebody needs to lead the way, and if you aren't willing to make that change, somebody else will. And I think that those who aren't willing to innovate are going to get left behind.